الله أكبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة
اللهم لا حول ولا قوة إلا
بالله حي على الصلاة
اللهم لا حول
حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر الله أكبر
لا إله إلا الله
اللهم رب ازدعى الدم وصلاة قديم اسم محمد المصير فضي محثن وقم محمد وعدتني كان لتخل معاد رضيت بالله رب رب الإسلام دينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وصلى الله عليه وسلم وعليه وأصحابه وصلى الله عليه وسلم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الحمد لله إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهديه الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه أشهد أنه قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة ومحى الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين فصلاة وسلاما على عبدك ونبيك محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في سورة ياسين بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وجاء من أقصى المدينة رجل يسعى قال يا قوم اتبعوا المرسلين. وعن ابن عمر رضي الله عنه قال أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال أحب الناس إلى الله أنفعهم لعياله رواه الطبراني وحسنه الألباني أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. أما بعد All praise to Allah, all praise to Allah, the one, the only, the one who should be worshipped. I bear witness that he is the creator of this universe. And he is the one who should be worshipped. I bear witness that Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam is his messenger. True mercy sent to us if he followeth path. Amma ba'd. Always, when you move, we moved, especially the people above 25 like me. When I moved, I was searching, the main thing to search is to be near a mosque. A masjid. Why? Why you have to be near a masjid? So that when you try to have any connection to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the masjid is the nearest way to go to. And alhamdulillah, from 25 years or older, mosques are not that many now. Subhanallah, we have a mosque here from Mariva. It's everywhere now, alhamdulillah. Then really, you should only try your best to come closer to a mosque. Then, with that being said, the khutbah started. The khutbah today about Surah Yasin, and you know the beauty of Surah Yasin, you'll try to memorize it. I'll take only part of the ayat. The ayat today is about a man. Before the Prophet والسلام, in each city, Allah will send the Prophet. From our knowledge, almost more than 124,000 prophets and 314 messengers. Imagine humanity. The last one was the Prophet Muhammad. There is no prophet after him. And the question is, the Quran, when you read it, is it just a book of stories for the youth? Is it? Is the book of stories? No, it's our manual. Every ayah means something we have to reflect upon. And I picked this ayah today. وَجَاءَ مِنْ أَقْسَى الْمَدِينَةِ رَجُلٌ يَسْعَى. What's the story? In a city from the previous ages, Allah sent two messengers. The people of this city didn't care about them, didn't believe them. Allah sent another messenger. Three prophets in the same city. Three prophets in the same city. What do you think? What stubbornness this city is. And subhanAllah, with that being said, imagine now, part one of us is there with him. What are you going to say? I'm done my job. Allah sent three prophets. Allah didn't say that. Allah said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَجَاءَ مِنْ أَقْصَى الْمَدِينَةِ. A man came from the other side of the city. The other side of the city. He came walking. Or maybe, should I go? I shouldn't go. This debating by himself? No. Allah said, يَسْعَى. Sa'i means what? Moving quickly. Moving quickly towards them. And you ask yourself, why he's doing that? Doesn't he know that these people disagreed with the prophets? Doesn't he know that there are three prophets there? He knows. But what should you do? What did he do? From the manual, we take that part. وَجَاءَ مِنْ أَقْسَى الْمَدِينَةِ رَجْلٌ يَسْعَى. Then, what did he say? He came in, talked to the people now. What are you going to say? He starts saying the beauty of Islam. Islam? Yeah, you don't know that all the prophets are Muslimin? All the prophets are Muslimin. When you hear about Jesus, may peace be upon him, these people around him is Muslimin. Sayyidina Musa, the people around him are Muslimin. Every religion, the Prophet himself is a Muslim. That's why we will meet all of us, inshallah. That in the deen, in the Allah, Islam, everyone is a Muslim. Now, then too, he starts conveying the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the people. Why are you disagreeing with them? Why are you disagreeing with them? Trying to give them a goodness. He's trying his part. Then he talked to his people. Follow the messengers. He's telling them, follow the messengers. You hear the shiuch, you hear the young, follow the Islam. Try to read the Quran. Try to understand. Try to follow the footsteps of this person. He's trying. He's trying. And then he said a specific thing, that they don't need anything from you. They are not asking for money. Maybe if they're asking for money, maybe you have, okay, they're looking for a job. But no. لَا يَسْأَلُكُمْ أَجْرًا. They don't want anything from you. They just want you to be on the right path. That's it. That's it. SubhanAllah. And now, the hardest part, I believe, in this ayat. وَمَا لِيَ لَا أَعْبُدُ الَّذِي فَطَرَنِي. He's now claiming, he's saying that I worship Allah. How many times when you're confronted, are you a Muslim? No, say it, I'm a Muslim. Don't worry, you're scared. Say it. Our Muslim woman who wear hijab, I believe, I'm telling everyone, if you are a hijab, you're taking reward, like it or not. Just wearing the hijab, walking on the street, you are doing da'wah. Just without saying a word. Wearing the hijab is da'wah. Then really, what should you men do? Support. Show it. Try your best to show a Muslim. How? Sometimes prayer comes in anywhere. I was traveling anywhere in the world. Alhamdulillah, now even in the airport now there are mosques. Before, when I was traveling, there wasn't mosques. There wasn't. Any airport didn't have mosques. I try. Even my son with me and said, let's pray in this side. Let's stand there and pray. Try to show that you're a Muslim. Don't worry. Don't feel scared. We are Muslims. This man in the story, he went and stood in front of his people. And he knows the penalty, and the penalty, I'll say it, what will happen to him later. Then he showed that he's Muslim. He's even proud. He's proud to be a Muslim. He's proud. How many of us, when you start job working, you want to pray on Friday, and your manager tells you, sorry, you cannot pray Friday. You have to have a meeting on that time. When I came here, I'd have this. I said, no. I have to go and pray. And my manager was testing me. Okay, how about 1 o'clock? I said, no. It was winter that time. I cannot. I have to go and pray. And it was by the one jama'ah at that mosque. It's Turkish mosque until now. Anadolia mosque. I was praying there. Only one jama'ah. 12:30 to 1:30. One. No. I said that 2, I'll be here. Okay. I'm a Muslim. I'm proud of being Muslim. My rizq is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I stayed with this company until almost 15 years of my life. I stayed with them. Don't worry about rizq. Wallahi, don't worry about rizq. We're scared, but don't worry. Talk. I have to pray. I have to pray. That's it. Full stop. Next. Okay? Then, and now to support the prophets. Do the prophets need support? Yes. Did our Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam get some support? Yes! He even gets support from himself when a mu'jiza, when a miracle happened with him. That ashhadu anni Rasulullah. He's proud of himself. He said, I am Prophet. I'm a Prophet. Sometimes he needs support. When his uncle and his wife died, what happened? All the support of this world gone. What Allah did? He took him in a support outside. You are here. You have our support, O Muhammad, alayhi salatu wasalam. Support. Especially people above 26. Don't sometimes you need to say to someone, I had this. A brother came to me and said, you're good, don't worry. Move on. So many calamities happen in life. Wallahi, the young people, when you go older, you will hit by calamities. You need a little bit. You're good. You're going the right path. Don't worry. From disease to out of work, you need some support. And that's what the man said in Surah Yasin. Then what? He's referring everything to Allah. If Allah wants something good or bad to me, I believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I believe it will stand. If it's good, thank you, Allah, for giving me good. If it's hard, I will have sabr on it until it passes. I'll have sabr on it until it passes. My son is disobeying me. Make dua. My son is sick. Make dua. Connect to Allah. My daughter is having a fight with me. Make dua. Extra dua, and I'll say it in the end. Connect to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But this man didn't make dua only. He did his job first. That's what I'm saying. You have to work and talk and try. My daughter was taking off the hijab. Talk to her. Why you're taking off the hijab? When you talk to the parents, said, oh, she has the right to do whatever she likes. Okay, if your daughter comes to you and tells you, I will drop university, will you tell her, no, we will be fighting. Up and down, you have to finish university. You are. And when it checks the hijab, it's her right. Yeah, you have to talk. Yeah, it's her right, but you have to talk. Your son is not praying. Talk. At least the minimum thing, talk to him. Pray with me. I like to pray in the mosque and he's not coming. When you go home, pray with him. Really? Can I pray again? Yes. Any prayer? Yes. Even Asr? Yes. Pray any prayer. Pray in the mosque, try. And then if you go home, my son, Muhammad, did you pray? No, I'll pray with you. But Father, you prayed at the mosque. Still, I'll pray with you. It's okay. Pray. Do your job. Do your due diligence. Wallahi, it's very simple sometimes. I know, Baba, I won't pray today. Okay. Tomorrow. Huh? You're tired yesterday. Let's do it today. Let's pray Isha. You have to try. Do your job. Don't get out of your job and say, I'm making dua. Oh Allah. Yeah, oh Allah at the end. And that's what the end happens. But he did her due diligence. He went, support, and said, I am a mu'min. I believe in the prophets. I'm following them. And definitely, they told him to go back. Right? He said, no. I'm supporting them. I'll stand behind the truth. How many times you requested to stand beside the truth and you said, it will cause me harm. What's the big deal? A little bit harm in the sake of Allah, it's okay. Sometimes you need it to strengthen yourself. Life is not that simple. Strengthen yourself. Then, what the man happened? The story said that they killed the prophets, by the way. This city, they killed the three prophets. And they killed him. And they killed the man. Allah didn't talk about the prophets. He talked about, subhanAllah, he talked about the man. After he died, what happened? He's a good man. Wallahi, if you think about it, he's a good man. After he went to Jannah. Huh? قَالَ يَا لَيْتَ قَوْمِي يَعْلَمُونَ Oh Allah, tell my people, I went to Jannah. Until now, we're reading the same ayat. Right? We're reading the same ayat that he went to Jannah. Not only that, he made dua that Allah will tell the people after him that he was forgiven. He was forgiven. Everything is gone from him. يَا لَيْتَ قَوْمِي يَعْلَمُونَ بِمَا غَفَرَ لِي رَبِّي Allah forgave me. Allah forgave me. Don't you want the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This is your homework. Try your best. Then, ادعو إلى سبيل ربك. Try your best to make dua. بالحكمة والموعظة الحسنة. Try your best to make dua. Extra dua. To yourself and to all your surroundings. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لكم فاستغفروا يا فوز المستغفرين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا واسرافنا في امرنا وتصرفنا وصالح اللهم ارحمنا اللهم اغفرنا ان الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا اما بعد What's our homework today? What should you or me do? I'll start with me first. Everyone, by the way, you have to start with yourself all the time. يا الذين لما تقولون ما لا تفعلون? Why you do something? Say something you don't do. كبر مقتا عند الله كبر مقتا عند الله أن تقولوا ما لا تفعلون when you say something try to abide with it yourself first do it yourself first before you ask your kids to do then what's our homework from this khutbah first we try to when we stand beside the truth we are gaining what إبراء الزمة what do I mean by that When we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what are you going to tell Him? About anything happening around you. Why didn't you do anything? Oh, I cannot do it. Allah knows. You can do something. You can make a difference in life. You can make a change in life. Did you try? The people who are came here to build a mosque, building a mosque in Miraval. Allah, if you can, they can stay home, relax, sit on the couch, do nothing. You can do that. Yeah, someone will debate with me, they will be rewarded sitting on the couch? No. But they will be questioned because they can do it. Why didn't you do it? Me. Anyone. I'm starting with me. What happened if I dropped? What happened? Allah will question me. You have the abilities to do it. Why didn't you do it? A brother who memorized the Quran, why didn't you teach? Try to teach even your kids. But my kids, okay, teach others. I have a sheikh when he came, I remember a long time ago. If you want to teach your kids, teach the friends of your kids. Teach the friends of your kids. And I took this advice, by the way. To teach my family, my son, I teach the friends of my son. And they are his included. My daughter, I bring them, the friends of my daughter, come home. And I lecture them. Not lecture, you cannot say lecture. I'd say it in a way that they will not feel that it's a lecture. I talk about hijab a little bit. I talk about Islam a little bit. And then my daughter is sitting, right? She will learn. This is the easy way. The young people here are sitting. They are your future. Imagine you have $1 million in the bank and they are not sitting with us when they are 20. How much are you going to pay to bring them back? How much are you going to pay if you have $1 million in the bank and your daughter is going with her boyfriend? What happened? Are you happy with your $1 million in the bank? Do your job. Do your due diligence. I'm not saying that you tried and they did it. It's okay. If they tried, we have the story of Sayyidina Nuh. Definitely he tried with his son. And still, he died as a kafir. It's okay. Did he do his job? تُعَذِيرُ إِلَى اللَّهِ. That's one. Two, I need everyone to try to come closer to a mosque. If you're living away, if you're working away, far away, and you live beside your work, no, live beside your mosque, and you drive. Why? Because it's important to come to the mosque in your loo time, in your in weekend. Come to the mosque. Find the mosque and try to live beside it. This is the number two. Three, try your best to do something, whatever the thing is good. Don't live in this life without doing anything. Simple things, wallahi. A brother here, he's just after Aisha prayer, he goes and collect the garbage. I saw him. I can do it too, by the way. But when I saw him, wallahi, I'm very happy. Let him do it. This is the hasana makhfiyya. Let him do it. A brother is recording. Let him do it. A brother is trying to do something, collecting garbage from the ground, from the mosque. After each khutbah, sometimes there is garbage there. He picks it up and throw it out without anyone knowing. It's between you and Allah. It's between you and Allah. I'm leaving and there are brothers who are collecting for the mosque. I'll put $1, $2, something, whatever. Is it good? Yes. Yes, you don't know. Maybe this mosque is better than that one and this dollar will take you to Jannah. We don't know which dollar will take you to Jannah. Every place I go in a mosque, I find the mosque, I put $1 there. You don't know which dollar will take you to Jannah. You don't know that part. And better, if you have your son, your daughter, give them the dollar and let them put it themselves. You take double the ajra. I always say that, teaching them and giving out the same. Number four, try. So many times we calculate, what if I do this? What is the outcome of it? If you're doing for Allah, don't worry about it. Allah is the one who's counting. I can see a brother here. I will not look at him. Sometimes he comes, a tap is not working. He fixes it. What's the big deal about it? Oh yeah, we don't know. The water coming out of it, if the tap is not fixed, the water will come out, right? Each drop of this water is in his hasanat. Because he did it. Right? Imagine that the shoes in the washroom. How many times you go to the washroom and you flip on something, on the one of the shoes. You put it back on the drawer. And in that place. And you're done. Allah knows that if you leave it there, you don't know. $1, you put it in the sake of Allah. You don't know how far it goes. Anyone who's over 25 like me, I was thinking, okay, I'll come here. For 5 years, I'll go back. But I tried to live beside a mosque. And subhanAllah, my life changes. And I'm here almost now 25, 26 years. That's how we have to work. Work and try to work for the sake of Allah. Finishing the last one. After we're done our jobs, we did everything. What can we do? The last thing? Dua. دعاء. Raise your hands to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with a دعاء. Remember that. Make extra دعاء for everything. You don't need anything from Allah. You're so rich that you don't need anything from Allah. Everyone needs something from Allah. You need a wife. You need دعاء, money, health. You need whatever. Make دعاء to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before we got this mosque, we made extra دعاء. Wallahi. That Allah will guide us to buying or not. Extra dua. Because really, we don't know. It was a winery here. It was a bar. Should we go ahead? Should we make dua? And don't worry about it. Allah will get it. And now, subhanAllah, 10 years now, it's a mosque. And so on. Make extra dua. And I have a dua I want to share with you. I said it here in the Khatira, and I want to share it with you. Dua Dr. Muhammad Ratib Nabulsi. He said he was sitting and he said that he prepares the khatira, his lesson for 7 hours. When I hear that, wallahi, I prepare the khatira maybe hour or 2 hours. I think, yes, I did a good job here. But he did it for 7 hours. And after he's leaving, I'll say it in Arabic and I'll translate it. The Arabic part, he said, he make a dua when he's going to his lesson. What he's saying, اللهم أنا أضعف عبادك شرفتني بمعرفتك والدعوة إليك إن علمت صدق نيتي فاحفظني لها واحفظها لي وإن علمت خلاف ذلك عالجني قبل الموت ولا تمتني حتى ترضى عني. If you hear it in Arabic, والله it's beautiful. But anyway, I'll translate it. He said, who is Muhammad Ratib Nawasi? You have to search it. He's one of the highest scholars in Islam. Now, he said, oh Allah, I am your weakest of your people, of your servants. You servants, not people. Servants, ibadak, servants. You bestowed me that you made me on da'wah. And knowing you, you bestowed me from knowing you and putting me in da'wah. If you know that my intention is good, my intention is right, keep it for me. How many times you ask our intentions? Keep it for me. And if you know different than that, what? Fix it. Only, and don't make me die before you are happy with me. Don't make me die before you are happy with me. This is Muhammad Ratib al-Nabulsi. Not me, not any one of us. He's trying his best to give the khutbah and trying to make dua. That's what I want everyone to do. You do your due diligence, you try your best and make dua. Make dua to connect to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتولنا فيمن توليت اللهم تقبل منا رمضان اللهم تقبل منا رمضان اللهم تقبل منا رمضان اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمن سبقنا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين وقوموا لصلاتكم ورحمكم الله وأقم الصلاة. الله يجزيك خير يا عم, ربنا يسعدك. سجل؟ طيب أخي ميلا.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
جزاك الله خير. حقا لا إله إلا الله. استووا تراصوا اعتدلوا. Feel the mosque inside first inshallah. We'll give it 5 more seconds. Try to fill the gaps. Try to clear your niyyah inshallah. You pray Jumaah inshallah. بسم الله. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله. الله أكبر. اللهم اهدنا. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. آمين. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
السلام على عباد الله الصالحين أشكر لي الله وأشكر رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى إبراهيم
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
السلام عليكم.